Tonight, I'd like to show you something, an object that we all own and as adults use every single day of our lives. It's our phones. Our phones can do some pretty unique things. They can keep entire libraries filled with memories. We can chat and see anyone from around the world at any time. The world is literally at our fingertips. It's an incredible piece of technology, but it has no heart. So tonight, I'd like to create an emotional piece of magic connecting to one person in this audience, creating a personal memory that we can all experience together using just this phone. David, I'm gonna open the calculator. I would like you to hold the calculator and the phone. Alicia, Amanda, and Simon, I would like each of you to create a special memory, a specific date in time that means something to you. This can be an anniversary, a birth of a loved one, or just a special occasion. Simon, I'm going to come to you first. What is the day and the month you're thinking of?
It's February the 14th.
February 14th. Why that date?
When Eric was born.
Okay, amazing. A day you'll never forget.
Yeah.
David, can you please type 1402 into the calculator and then press multiply?
Okay.
Amanda, can you please tell me the day and the month you're thinking of?
The 10th of December.
The 10th of December. And why is that date so meaningful to you?
That's when I married my husband.
When you married your husband. David, this time, can you put 10, 1, 2 into the calculator and again press multiply?
1, 2.
Alicia, what is the day and month you're thinking of?
I'm thinking of the 1st of October.
The 1st of October. And again, yes. Why is this day meaningful to you?
It's my daughter who's here. She was born on that day.
Okay, so yeah. Again, you can never forget that day.
Exactly.
David, put 1.
Yes.
1, 0. And this time press divide. Now, David, you're going to put in a unique number, a number that only you should really know. You're going to put in your 4-digit banking PIN code into the calculator. I tell you what, we're going to move the camera for this bit so no one can see. I'm going to look away. Once you've put it in, press equals.
Okay.
Is that done?
Yes.
Okay. I'm gonna take the phone. So David, that was 71,059, right? So. Thank you. Now David, can you also take out your credit card from your pocket, please?
Where is this heading?
You'll soon see. Thank you. Simon, I'm gonna come down to you as I'd like to show you something special with David's credit card. Watch. Simon, can you hold out your hand for me? Because right now, at this moment, the phone is actually changing into something else. Not only has it got heavier, it really has changed completely into a block of metal. But look, only moments ago, using special dates and memories from your lives, we created one unique number, a number that no one could have predicted. That number was 71,059. Look, engraved into the metal is one number, 71,059. But wait, that's not it. Simon, can you tell everyone your birthday, please?
October the 7th.
And what year?
1959.
So that's the 7th of the 10th, 1959. Simon, this is for you.
Whoa! What?
That was brilliant.
What? Good night. We can be the...
Before I start tonight, I'd like to point out the box suspended above the stage. I'll come back to that in a moment. 6 months ago, I took a phone and I turned it into this block of metal. Using special dates and memories from your lives and David's PIN code, we created one unique number that ended up being
engraved into the metal. That number was also Simon's birthday. Ashley, you've been here before. You've performed on this stage. If you could use one word to describe the feeling of what it's like to be up here, what would it be?
One word. Incredible.
It's definitely incredible. A little bit terrifying, but definitely incredible.
Yeah, I would have said terrifying.
Now, Ashley, Amanda, Alicia, and David, I want each of you to think about a turning point in your careers, maybe even the moment that led you on the path of success. Ashley, when you first formed Diversity,
yep.
What was the one time of the day that you look forward to the most? The exact hour and minute.
Wow.
Oh, what a question.
That's a big question. Okay, I would say 12:01, like the start of the next day. I love what I do so much that I want the next day to come.
Okay, love that. Amanda, in the first round, I asked you for a special memory. You said it was the day you got married to your husband. I want you to think of a career highlight, one what's maybe more memorable than any of the others. I want you to think of the exact date and month. I know it's hard.
Oh,
that's
gosh.
Hard to remember the date, isn't it?
The exact date, I probably don't remember. Probably be when I did the West End for the first time. I was Millie and thoroughly modern Millie. And it was in October 2003, but I couldn't tell you the date.
If you could take a random guess, what would you think it would be?
Okay, I'm gonna say it was October the 5th, 2003.
October the 5th, 2003.
Yes.
Now, Alicia, excluding the UK and the US, because I think they're a little bit obvious, when you got your first record deal,
yeah.
What was the one country you couldn't wait to go and perform in?
The Falkland Islands. You're very big there. You're big there.
Japan.
Japan?
Yeah.
Why Japan?
I'm fascinated with Japan. It's an amazing country and they embraced mystique. And we just always had an incredible time when we were there.
I'd love to go there myself one day. It sounds awesome. Now, David, when you first went into showbiz, if there was any actor or actress you could have received a message from giving you a bit of advice, who would it have been from?
Rowan Atkinson.
Rowan Atkinson?
Yes.
And what do you think he would have said to you?
Well, I did get his autograph when I was a kid. And I said, what advice can you give an aspiring comedian? And he said, don't do it.
Don't do it.
And then I met him years later and obviously didn't remember, but I reminded him of it.
I'm glad you did do it.
Thank you. Someone is, see?
6 months ago, I never knew how much this block of metal would change my life. But I need to go back 6 months ago when this wasn't a block of metal and was a real phone. My screensaver from 6 months ago, the time was 1 minute past midnight.
Ooh.
Amanda,
wow.
The date is the 5th of October when you was in West End. Alicia, you said you wanted to perform in Japan.
No, I did perform in Japan.
You said you did perform in Japan. And David, I even just got a text from Rowan Atkinson which says,
what?
Don't do it. But as impressive as this is, people might just think, nah, technology, you know? The box which has been suspended above the stage the entire time. Look. I've not been near this at all. Locked inside. Is a sealed tube with a folded up piece of paper. I put this prediction in that box before I went on stage tonight. I wrote down 1 minute past 12. the date, the 5th of October. Japan. Rowan Atkinson. And there was even a message which said, don't do it.
That was good.
But that's not it.
Oh, come on.
What?
Ashley, at the beginning, I asked you to use one word to describe the feeling of performing on this stage.
Mm-hmm.
You said, incredible.
Incredible.
The sketch pad, which has been sitting in front of you this entire time, I wrote down one thing tonight on the back of it, which was...
Don't wind me up.
Incredible. Each time I've walked onto this stage, I've been holding this phone and talking about your memories. Well, tonight, I thought it'd only be right that I get to create one last one. Inside this box of memories are a few of my favourite moments from my time here on BGT. The phone I turned into metal on my first audition. Some photos of my favourite memories. Ball of rope. A small glass I was drinking out of to celebrate getting into the finals. Don't judge me. But this is what I'm looking for. Ant and Dec, can you stand near the box and make sure no one touches it?
Yes, sure.
Each time before I've came out onto this stage, I've been messing around with this deck of cards backstage to try and help me relax. And tonight, I thought it'd only be right to create one more moment of magic. Amanda, before
yes.
I get you to pick a card, can you please sanitize your hands? Thank you. I'm gonna count through the cards. In fact, Amanda, just point to one. That one there?
Yeah.
Okay. We're gonna take the card. I'm gonna rip the corner. In fact, Amanda, you take the corner, you rip it off. I want you to take out your phone. And you're gonna go onto social media.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you're gonna search for my profile, Damien Magician. Found me?
Yeah, got it.
I mean, we've made...
I'm just gonna follow you back, sorry.
Wow, we've made three times, you don't even follow me.
Ouch! Really embarrassing,
ouch.
Sorry. I'm following you.
Amanda, hand me the corner of the card. Tap the first image as well once you're done.
Tap the first image?
Yep. Watch. Amanda,
yes.
The card just travels and lands in your phone and onto my social media. If you just scroll up through the images, you'll see there's a picture. A corner of a card.
Oh my God.
Click the image, but look, here's the mad thing. Match it up, you rip the card. Make sure it matches that corner perfectly.
Wow.
But let's take this a step further. Hand me your card. We'll put this into the middle, just like that. And it vanishes instantly. And it lands back in the phone. No, I mean really in the phone. Amanda, may I?
Should we just...
Yeah, it's okay. Look. Inside...
No way!
...your phone case is a card. You take it, show it to them, let them see it. I don't want to look. But I said I wanted to create one more memory tonight. So tonight, I'm going to do just that. No smoke, no mirrors, no sleeves. So many of us store our memories and our photos on our phones and on social media. Well, me, I'm just that little bit old school. Watch. My photos of my favourite times here on BGT. Meeting Ant and Dec for the first time. Getting four yeses on the first audition. Actually, incredible. And even the selfie I just took up on the stage. But if the photos of my memories from my box are here, Amanda, where's your phone?
I don't know. You're not gonna smash it, are you?
Can you please pick up the box and Deck, if you can bring the glass and meet me in front of Amanda's desk. No one has been near this box the entire time. Deck, can you please place the glass in front of Amanda?
Perfect for me.
Inside. The ball of string, if you could place the box on here. Guys, thank you so much.
No. No.
Amanda, place your hand on the base of the glass. Watch.
No way.
Grab the phone.
Yes, it was. It was my phone, yes.
Pick it up. Switch it on. Amanda, is that your phone?
Yes, that is my phone.
Guys, thank you for the memories and good night.
Look, there's the picture of my family.